This is CNN Breaking News.
The renowned film critic Roger Ebert has died. That's according to the Chicago Sun-Times. We want to bring in the host of Showbiz Tonight here on HLN, Mr. A.J. Hammer. A.J., renowned, legendary, and now we're hearing this. We heard earlier in the week that the cancer had returned.
Yeah, and this is that makes this really some pretty unexpected and of course, sad news tonight, Don. The legendary Pulitzer Prize-winning movie critic Roger Ebert has died today. He spent more than 45 years reviewing movies for the Chicago Sun-Times, which is pretty remarkable. And, of course, he became very famous giving his thumbs up or thumbs down for three decades on his television show with Gene Siskel. He died from complications of the cancer that he had been battling, according to the Chicago Sun-Times. It was always that quick wit and that thumbs up, thumbs down movie review that we love so much about the man. It earned him fame as one of America's most prominent film critics. He was a native of Illinois. His love of cinema came at a very early age. He began writing film reviews for the Chicago Sun-Times in the late 60s, and in 1975 was the first film critic to ever win the Pulitzer Prize for criticism. In 1970, he dabbled in screenwriting, co-authoring Beyond the Valley of the Dolls with Russ Meyer. Certainly knew a great deal about what it takes to make a good film. And then it was in 1976 when he teamed up with a competitor, Chicago Tribune film critic Gene Siskel, to host the weekly movie review program on local TV. Within a few years, that went into syndication, and Siskel and Ebert's thumbs up, thumbs down rating system soon became their trademark that everybody still uses today when we're talking about films. It was 1999 when Gene Siskel died from complications stemming from a brain tumor operation. The show's title at that time was changed to Roger Ebert and the Movies. And a short time later, fellow Sun-Times columnist Richard Roper became the permanent co-host of the show. It was later titled Ebert and Roper. Roger Ebert also published annual collections of his film reviews, as well as several film guides, and not one to be left behind. He embraced social media. He was actively tweeting. He never lost his voice despite battling both thyroid and salivary gland cancers. And he underwent numerous surgeries in recent years, Don. Mm-hmm. And again, as you said earlier this week, we all got the news that his cancer had recurred. We did not realize he was at the stage that he was at. But Roger Ebert, a beloved American icon, dead today at the age of 70.
Mm-hmm. And one of those interviews that we're seeing there was one time when I interviewed them, and his wife, Chaz, who's a friend, talked about, you know, just she was there by his side, the lady you see by his side, and talked about it. She was so excited, AJ, that he was getting this new machine, and you would hear the voice of Roger Ebert again. And she was there by his side through and through. And it's just sad to hear. We all hope that he would just, you know, go the distance and would live a much longer life. But again, according to the Chicago Sun-Times, they are reporting that Roger Ebert has died. AJ, we look forward to your report. Thank you very much. We're going to send it off now to the lead and Jake Tapper.